Hello and welcome to a new video. In today's video I will show you my new addition to the collection, the ROJA Oligarch. This is a citrus spicy perfume released in 2016 by ROJA Dove. It has only this size, 50 milliliter, and it cost about 290 euro for this. I'm not sure if this is easy to get in the US or in America, but in here you can get it from ROJA shop or from Selfridges. I found it online, so just from these two places. This is how the bottle looks like. This is the bottle that is also used for the perfumes, so the Enigma and Elysium. It has here this emblem from Russia, and here it says a fragrance by ROJA Dove. It opens like this, and the perfume is snug inside in here. So let's take it out. This cap is metallic. You have the ROJA logo in here. You have the ROJA logo on the sides, the batch code on the top, and on the back a fragrance by ROJA Dove. The main question every perfume lover asks itself, as far as I know, is this perfume worth the hype, or is just overhyped because it's not so easily available? So I can tell you that I had two bottles so far. This is my second bottle of it, and it is a really, really good perfume. It has a ton of notes. As top notes, you will have bergamot, lavender, lime, so really, really citrusy start. Then in hard notes, you'll have orange blossom, jasmine from grass, which is one of the favorites of ROJA Dove, some coconut, just a little sweet coconut, apple, tonka, vanilla, oak moss. So like I said, it does have a ton of notes, and also it has a lot of changes during the lifetime of the perfume. On various websites like perfume.net or Fragrantica, people associate this to Terre de Hermes, or the toilette. And between these two, I can tell you that there is a big difference. Terre de Hermes is an earthy, woody type of perfume, and it has this loud, screechy type of smell, like very, very bubbly, I would say. And Oligarch, on the other hand, is a perfume that it will be more subtle, not so loud. But after you spray it, the sillage is quite strong, so about half a meter or even 1 meter around you, everybody can smell it around you because it has a very nice sillage. And it's not a loud perfume. It's not a, hey, I am here, look at me, like Ombre Nomade from Louis Vuitton's example. This is a very classy and subtle type of perfume. In my opinion, this is a perfume for a mature gentleman, so 40 plus, I would say. I'm not yet there, and I enjoy it, but I can sense that is not very youthful, or not for people under 30 for sure. So take this into consideration if you would like to buy this one and use this one. The sprayer is really, really nice. I like it. And you get this nice and subtle mix of citrus aromas and a lot of bergamot. In comparison with Terre de Hermes, which starts very loud and then it becomes like earthy, Hermes smells for me like as if you go into a wet forest and you walk there and you have furs around and you have this earthy type of smell. This is how Terre de Hermes smells. But the ROJA will smell like nice citruses, and then it becomes a bit spicy, and then also some cut grass that is in here, so this calms, this gives you a good mood when you use it. This is a considered a chypre, but for me it smells more like a fougère, like a spicy aromatic fougère, let's say. There is a perfume on the market called Fougère Royale from Houbigant Paris, and the version from 2010, Rojadov also helped them to make it, let's say, actual and modern. So you can see the similarities that the master perfumer Roja helped Houbigant and also created later this this really nice perfume, the Oligarch. After the initial blast of citruses, these two are so different. So absolutely, who is saying that this one smells like a better Terre de Hermès? No, they have a similarity which goes away in a few minutes. And then this one becomes subtle, becomes very luxurious. If you think about buying it, it only comes in this 50 milliliter bottle, which is the same as for Elysium Parfum, Enigma Parfum, and all the Parfum versions. It is very luxurious, and the cap is really heavy and metallic. And the sprayer is also very good, like I said. And you don't have a 100 milliliter version for it, like you would have as example for Elysium Special Edition. This perfume has a lot of notes and it is very complex. Even if it's citrusy, like I said, this is something that you will not find so often around you. Like, if you wear this, you can be sure that you will not have the risk that somebody else smells like this when you go to a meeting or to meet your friends. And also for the fact that it's not so easy to get, this is an extra layer of uniqueness, if you want. So you can be sure that if you want to smell special and to have a smell that not everybody around you has, like let's say Dior Sauvage or even the Aventus, which became so popular that now most of the people are wearing it, this one will not bring this risk to you. So you will really feel and smell unique. And the comparison with Terre de Hermès stops in a few minutes, and that's it. So whoever says that this is a better version of this most likely didn't smell this, or just doesn't want to get into the complexity of analyzing them. Another question which people ask themselves regarding this perfume is if it's really worth the hype, because it's a very hyped perfume. And I can say that it is really up to the expectations, and it is really worth the hype, because it's very nice, very complex, smells wonderful in dry down, smells wonderful at the start. It has this very nice and subtle and luxurious type of smell which will accompany you the whole day, because it's also very long lasting. So it's not just a quick blast of citruses and then goes away. So that's also something that you should take into consideration. So far, like I said, I only see pros for this perfume. The only cons that I would see for Oligarch are the high price. So this is about 600 euro for 100 milliliter. The fact that it's not so easily available, only from Roja or Selfridges you can get it. And also there, it's not always in stock because it's so loved, and sometimes you will not see it in stock and you need to wait for weeks or even months to get your bottle. And another con is that due to the fact that it's for a more mature audience, let's say, I don't see it catching up with younger perfume lovers, so 20, 25, even 30. But yeah, that's just my opinion. This is also a great addition to my collection, and I wanted to have this perfume for a long time, and now finally I got the chance to have it. I ordered it directly from Roja, and I also got a free atomizer, a 7.5 milliliter perfume, which is nice, and I really appreciate this service from them. I will put the link down into the description. Please comment down below what is your experience with Roja perfumes and if you like the Oligarch and if you had the chance to test it. And I hope to see you soon on the channel Healthy. Thank you very much for watching and see you soon. Bye bye.